Notice anything special about this radio? There's no tuning control. All these buttons here are just fake, and this is just a logo. It's not a display. Only has volume and tone. And there's no tuning on the back either. You get a switch for external or internal antenna, jack for the external antenna, and the AC line cord. That's it. That's because this is an FM subcarrier radio. In the same way that FM radio stations use subcarriers to transmit stereo sound, they can use subcarriers to transmit either audio programming or digital data. One use of which is RDS, radio data system, which is used on many car radios these days, especially in Europe, to provide title and artist information for the song that's currently playing, and to show the radio station's slogan and other things like that. That's a digital use of subcarriers. This is an analog use, dating back to at least the 1950s, if not even earlier. Oh, yeah. This is the subcarrier of FM radio station 88.3 WBGO in Newark, New Jersey, known as Jazz 88. This is their 67 kHz subcarrier, which is carrying Italian programming, known as ICN. When I got this radio, I didn't know any of that, so I had to look it up online. I was able to figure it out by looking up ICN. So this is a fixed frequency subcarrier radio. It's only designed to pick up that 67 kHz subcarrier. I suppose internally there may be some tremors to adjust the tuning, but so far I haven't taken it apart, so I don't know for sure. But for now, this is only designed to pick up this station through that subcarrier. Fidelity is not that great. There's a lot of hiss because it's an analog signal. Sort of like the hiss you get when receiving FM stereo from a weaker signal. You get the same kind of hiss on the subcarrier when the signal's not that great. And even with the tone turned all the way up, the treble above maybe 5 or 6 kHz just isn't there, so it's kind of a narrow band sound as well. Although that music doesn't sound really Italian right now, they do have news and talk programming in Italian. I believe they carry some programming from RAI in Italy, which is one of their big radio networks over there. Io sono un'isola e le stelle mi hanno circondato e se cammino nel silenzio troverò un sentiero per ritornare sulla strada. Reception gets better when you aim the antenna towards a window, so the telescoping antenna here is pretty nice. But when I fold it up, I barely get any reception anymore. There is no indication of anywhere of who made this, so it may be custom built on a limited basis just for this station's listeners. You can see it's not real wood grain, and the vinyl they use to simulate wood grain is not the best either. It's kind of bubbling up in certain areas, and the lettering is a little bit uneven. The bottom just has some feet. There's no manufacturer's decal showing where it was made or anything. So now let's take a look inside. There you have it. Here's the very basic power supply. Now this board just sort of swings around loosely, so not very good construction. Here's the switch for internal or external antenna and the jack for external antenna. This is where the internal antenna connects. There's a speaker. 8 ohms, 2.5 watts. And then there's the circuit board. Do not see any model number or manufacturer indication unless it's on the other side. Basically just a bunch of coils there and a crystal to set the tuning, and a couple ceramic filters there, CFT, ceramic filter, 455 kilohertz. There are some connectors there that are not currently used for anything, some hot glue residue. So I can't really tell you much about it except what you can see here, unless I unglue the whole thing and try to look at the other side. But does not look easy to retune to a different frequency. You probably have to redo all those coils to match up to whatever new frequency you want to set it to. That right there is probably the audio output chip, because it has the wires going to the speaker right next to it. The back just sort of fits in like that. Obviously the front panel is custom molded plastic. So whatever company makes these, they just put the station's logo in this little insert here. I believe that phone number is still valid, because obviously the station is on the air, as you just heard. So that is the FM subcarrier radio receiving the 67 kHz subcarrier of WBGO in Newark, New Jersey, which is also transmitting HD radio, the digital method of broadcasting which is used here in America, to much disdain from radio enthusiasts. But it is possible to transmit both HD radio and subcarriers and RDS all at the same time, all within the frequency band allocated to the station. So thanks for watching.